Welcome back, everybody. My name is Philip, and if you are wanting to check out Luminar Neo for your next edit, or you're just looking for inspiration for your next edit, this is a good place to be. In this video, we will take this super sad image that I took from Castle Neuschwanstein from a moving gondola into a more fantastical version of itself that, to be honest, I kind of love to look at. If the editing style itself is not yours, more power to you, but might still be sweet to see the process in action. As usual, my editing does not have any order. It is very chaotic, so strap in. Let's do this and have a look at this step-by-step editing history. I won't be able to zoom in a lot as this edit is very heavy and Luminar struggles sometimes when you go back through your edit. So we will focus on larger editing steps. To start, I realized I have some dust spots in the sky, so I used the erase function to get rid of them in one click. Next, the foreground is a little empty. So my goal was to bring attention to the castle and the mountains in the back. One easy way to do that is by simply darkening the foreground. Something that will happen a lot over the next couple of minutes. If you want to darken something, I suggest darkening that subscribe button with your thumb. Yeah, okay, this one didn't even make sense. It's YouTube, you know, deal with it, moving on. Using another development module, I changed the temperature towards a more blue color. Ain't nobody got time for that yellow crap. Next, I added some saturation to the image and used the Accent AI filter to darken the sky. To be honest, I was happy there was anything at all, considering how washed out it looked. As we don't have a histogram in Luminar yet, skylum, this was quite the pleasant surprise. So, as I was in a dramatic mood, I darkened the sky even more with the Relight AI filter, which lets you control lighting near and far. Neat thing. Now, the trees in the foreground were still a little too attention-grabbing. So I thought, how do I make them a little less visible? An easy way to make them somewhat merge with each other, at least visually, is a mood filter, or a LUT, really. That changed the color mood of the image a bit, made it darker, and through the fading, it took some detail and attention from the foreground. I did love the direction of this, so I added a toning adjustment and essentially added even more dark blue into the image. At this point, I wasn't really sure where to go, so I thought, half jokingly, why not add some sun into this? And so I did, using the sun rays module. Once I did that, I was like, okay, let's see where this is going. At least it draws the attention to the castle. After darkening the immediate foreground a bit more, I added a vignette and removed some of the strong blue from the sky. With that sun in the image, we'll need some yellows back, so I started adding golden hour colors to the area of the sun to start with. This was then enhanced a bit with a color harmony adjustment, and another color adjustment brought out some color in the sky. Being adventurous, because you never know if Luminar can do it, I used the erase function to get rid of some of the elements in the foreground. Often this makes a photo easier on the eye, especially when working on wide scenes, it's just less clutter. I like the result, so moving on. After adding some contrast and darkening the foreground even more, I know, I darkened down the castle using a development module to make it fit better into this kind of new lighting we have got going on here. I did like it, but something was missing. And as we seemingly went nuts anyway, why not add some lens flares? This can easily be done by adding a layer, finding a nice lens flare on Canva or wherever, and changing its blend mode to screen. For me personally, this really rounds up the fantasy style of this particular image. So, looking at the complete before and after, I love this magical landscape we created. Do forgive my chaotic editing, but I do prefer the colors and the scene we have created now to the very boring and washed out image we started with. If you like what you saw and you're thinking about getting Luminar yourself, do make sure you use the link in the description as well as the promo code LETSIMAGE at checkout, first of all to save money, but also to support the channel if you so desire. Other than that, I shall see you next time and have a good one. Bye!